I envy you being able to vote. Not the actual ticking of the box, although it would be... Well, it would be nice to experience that once, but... The sheer joy of being partial.
Yes. Of course, one forgets that a sovereign... You're not entitled to vote.
No.
Still, you won't catch me feeling sorry for you. You might not be allowed to vote, ma'am. But it is your government.
Yes. I suppose that is some consolation. I haven't asked him yet.
Let's just recap on the details of those injuries, Maxine.
Yes, Nick. What they're saying is that the princess is in the intensive care unit of a southeast Paris hospital. She has concussion, a broken arm, and...
What was she doing in Paris? I thought she was supposed to be in London.
Oh, you know what she's like. Charles, isn't this awful? What are you going to do about the boys?
Let them sleep until we know more.
Oh, yes, that's sensible.
I should go to Paris. I told my people to start organising a jet.
What, a private one?
Yes.
But isn't that precisely the sort of extravagance they always attack us for?
How else am I supposed to get to Paris at this time of night? The airport at Aberdeen will be closed.
Charles, dear. Use the royal flight. They keep one plane on permanent standby in case I should kick the bucket.
No, Mummy, that's out of the question. This isn't a matter of state.
What are you talking about?
Diana's no longer a member of the royal family. She's not an HRH. This is a private matter.
She's mother to your grandchildren.
What is happening now?
I don't know. I can't hear. Everyone's shouting.
Tony Blair had gathered with members of his government.
A single black hearse crossed the tarmac, and a Royal Air Force Guard of Honour moved slowly forward.
Well, has anyone heard from the Spencers yet? Have they made up their minds when the funeral will be?
Well, I don't know. Nobody tells me anything.
President Clinton was with his wife when...
Apparently, the Prime Minister is on the phone for you.
Tell him to call back.
No, it's all right. I'll take it. Prime Minister.
Good morning, Your Majesty. Sorry to disturb, but I was just wondering whether you'd seen any of today's papers.
We've managed to look at one or two, yes.
In which case, my next question would be whether you felt some kind of response might be necessary.
No. I believe a few over-eager editors are doing their best to sell newspapers, and it would be a mistake to dance to their tune.
Under normal circumstances, I would agree. But, well, my advisers have been... taking the temperature among people on the streets. And, well, the information I'm getting is that the mood is quite delicate.
So, what would you suggest, Prime Minister? Some kind of a statement?
No, ma'am. I believe the moment for statements has passed. I would suggest flying the flag at half-mast above Buckingham Palace. And coming down to London at the earliest opportunity. It would be a great comfort to your people. And would help them with their grief.
Their grief? You imagine I'm going to drop everything and come down to London before I attend to my grandchildren who've just lost their mother. And you're mistaken. I doubt there is anyone who knows the British people more than I do, Mr. Blair, nor who has greater faith in their wisdom and judgment. And it is my belief that they will any moment reject this mood, which is being stirred up by the press, in favor of a period of restrained grief and sober private mourning. That's the way we do things in this country. Quietly, with dignity.
I have to talk to Lord Chamberlain about all this.
Oh, I have. And to Robert Fellows, and it seems they both agree with Mr. Blair.
I see.
Something's happened. There's been a change, some shift in values. When you no longer understand your people, Mummy, maybe it is time to hand it over to the next generation.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Remember the vow you took?
I declare that my whole life, whether it be long or short, shall be devoted to your service.
Your whole life? That is a commitment to God, as well as your people.
But what if my actions are damaging the crown?
Damaging it? You're the greatest asset this institution has. One of the greatest it has ever had. No, no. The problem will come when you leave. But you mustn't think about that now. Certainly not today.
Oh, Mummy.
You must show more strength. Reassert your authority. You sit on this powerful throne in Europe. Head of an unbroken line that goes back for more than 1,000 years. Do you think any of your predecessors would have dropped everything and gone up to London because a bunch of hysterics carrying candles needed help with their grief? As for that silly Mr. Blair with his Cheshire Cat grin.
Said earlier, perhaps was just that people grieving need to target their anger at somebody, and royal protocol might have been the thing. It got in the way. But royal protocol is being swept aside en masse today.
Those for you?
No.
Oh.
These are for you.
For me? Thank you. Thank you very much.
Top of the list is education reform.
Mm-hmm.
We want to